Croft tonight. It's an invitational pace. Some very good local horses and some good imports as well. Kenny Rice is trackside for us tonight, as he is each week, and he has Billy Perkins, who is the track announcer here, to talk about the fifth race, which you will see as well.
Thank you, Sharon. Billy, this shapes up to be a very exciting race. As we take a look, we have five local horses in it. Obviously, that generates a lot of local interest and a lot of local wagering here. And then you have some good horses coming in. Plus, you have Bill O'Donnell and you have John Campbell in this race.
That's true, Kenny. We're kind of proud of this race. It's a great warm-up for the Breeders' Crown. Probable favorite in the field, Deacon Lobel. He's coming off two wins in a row. The question there is, can he handle the half-mile racetrack? He's always raced on bigger ones. Another favorite in the field, our track record holder here last spring, GE's Roman Arrow. He turned a mile in 155. I believe it's still a season's record. And also in the field, a two-time invitational winner this fall already from the John Hogan stable, Hillbilly Orr, and he leaves from the two post, which will be an advantage. Other horses in the field, Sticks and Scones, a newcomer with Bill O'Donnell, the top driver in the country, along with Duncan's Ride, a hard-pounding pacer, Big Shift, Happy Seven, and Lumbering Mel. We look for a lot of speed tonight.
And with the speed, with the fact that we have a beautiful afternoon for racing here, it has been a great day in Maryland, and the night is beautiful right now. Do you think we're going to have a pretty fast time and some indication of what kind of time we can expect in the Breeders?
Last week, the race went 156-3. I can't see it going 56, 57, something like that. The Breeders' Crown, our track record is 2 minutes and a fifth on the trot. I can see that falling tonight.
I think most people do, don't you?
I believe so.
Okay, Billy, thank you very much. Look forward to your calls with us.
Thank you.
Sharon?
Thanks, Kenny, and we have